Welcome to Max class. In this video, I am going to explain the sums given in exercise 2.1 in the chapter Integers. Question number 7. From the following number lines, identify the correct and the wrong representations with reason. There are 5 representations are given. Subdivision 1. This representation is wrong because the numbers are not continuously marked as minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, etc. to the left of 0 and to the right of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But on the number line to the right of 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, etc. are marked. So, this representation is wrong. Subdivision 2. So, subdivision 2 on the number line, the numbers are marked as continuously marked. So, this representation of integers is correct. Subdivision 3. The representation is wrong because minus 2 is misplaced in the number line. So, this representation is wrong. Subdivision 4. This representation is correct. The numbers are marked at equal intervals in the correct order. To the right of 0, the numbers are marked as 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, etc. To the left of 0, minus 2, minus 4, minus 6, minus 8, etc. Subdivision 5. Here, negative integers are wrongly marked to the left of 0. So, this representation is wrong. Question number 8. Write all the integers between the given numbers. Subdivision A, 7 and 10. On the number line, the numbers are marked. The numbers between 7 and 10 are 8 and 9. Subdivision B, minus 5 and 4. The numbers between minus 5 and minus 4 are minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2 and 3. Subdivision 3. Minus 3 and 3. The numbers between minus 3 and 3 are minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2. Subdivision D, find the numbers between 5 and 0. The numbers between 5 and 0 are minus 4, minus 3, minus 2 and minus 1. Question number 9. Put the appropriate signs as less than, greater than or equal in the box. Subdivision 1. Minus 7-8. We know that minus 7 is to the left of 8. So, minus 7 is less than 8. Subdivision 2. Minus 8-7. Minus 8 is to the left of minus 7. Minus 8. So, minus 8 is less than minus 7. Subdivision 3. Minus 999-1000. Minus 1000 is to the left of minus 999. So, minus 999 is greater than minus 1000. Subdivision 4. Minus 111-111. -111 and -111 coincides in the number line. So -111 is equal to -111. Subdivision 5. 0-200. 0 is to the right of -200. So 0 is greater than -200. Arrange the following integers in ascending order. First, we separating the positive integers and the negative integers. Then arranging the positive integers in ascending order and negative integers in ascending order. Now arrange the given integers in ascending order. Subdivision 1. The given integers are -11, 12, -13, 14, -15, 16, -17, 18, -19 and -20. First, we write the positive integers and negative integers separately. The positive integers are 12, 14, 16 and 18. The negative integers are -11, -13, -15, -17, -19 and -21. The positive integers in ascending order. The positive integers in ascending order is 12, 14, 16 and 18. The negative integers in ascending order is -20, -19, -17, -15, -13 and -11. Now we arrange the given numbers in ascending order is -20, -19, -17, -15, -13, -11, 12, 14, 16 and 18. Subdivision 2. The given integers are -28, 6, -5, -40, 8, 0, 12, -1, 4, and 22. Positive integers are 6, 8, 12, 4, and 22. Negative integers are -28, -5, -40, -1. Now we arrange the positive integers in ascending order. 4, 6, 8, 12, and 22. The negative integers in ascending order -40, -28, -5 and -1. Here the number 0 is neither positive and nor negative and stand in the middle. So the given integers in ascending order equal to -40, -28, -5, -1, 0, 4, 6, 8, 12 and 22. Subdivision 3. The given integers are -100, +10, -1000, 100, 0, -1, +1000, +1 and -10. The positive integers are 10, +100, +1000 and +1. The negative integers are -100, -1000, -1 and -10. The positive integers in the ascending order 1, 10, 100 and 1000. The negative integers in ascending order -1000, -100, -10, -1. Here 0 stand in the middle as it is neither positive nor negative. So the given numbers in ascending order: -1000, -100, -10, -1, 0, 1, 10, 100 and 1000. Students, I hope you all have understood the given sums in exercise 2.1. Thank you.